Legislative session is over with the House and Senate gaveling out today, leaving a stack of bills for the governor's signatures. WJTV 12's Gerald Harris joins us now in the studio with the details. Gerald?
Byron, while leadership at the Capitol say the election in November didn't have much of a factor in the legislative session, some outsiders say it did.
Lawmakers are headed home after a session that didn't cause widespread drama.
It's an election year, and I think they played close to the vest on a number of things, except the fetal heartbeat. That plays well, I think, does it relate to it being an election year?
Dr. Stephen Rosman is the chair of Tougaloo's College's political science department and says there were some big wins during the session, beginning with rural broadband.
About 60% of people in rural areas don't have broadband, so it's good to allow the electric cooperatives to the ability to provide the broadband.
The legislature also tackled teacher pay, providing a $1,500 raise. Teacher advocacy groups lobbied for more. Rosman said the increase probably won't impact the election in a big way.
I don't know if teachers carry that much weight in this state. They perhaps should, but as far as the elections and electability, I don't think that's going to be a key issue.
Rosman adds the Landowner Protection Act and the Charitable Donors Bill were also notable legislation passed during the session. Rosman says not all the pressing issues for the state were addressed.
A few things positive, but I don't think with all of the needs of the state and the infrastructure needs and whatnot, I certainly can't give an A or a B or even a C to this legislature.
There are also some criminal justice reforms passed through the legislature.
And Byron, Dr. Rosman adds infrastructure and health care were left out of this session. And now that the session is over, it is officially campaign season. And stick with WJTV 12 as we're focused on politics. Byron?